Hello my good thespians, and I'll wait while you look up what that word means. And no, it doesn't mean that, but welcome to my channel, and I got a really quick tutorial on how to add an extension called Deforum to your Stable D. And no, that does not refer to your boyfriend or a sequel to the anime Initial D.
Deja vu, I've just been in this place before. Higher on the street, and I know it's my time to go. Going you and
it refers to the one and only Stable D. Fusion.
Uppercase T, uppercase P, the plan!
How's that for a French accent? For this tutorial I'm assuming you installed Stable Diffusion. If you haven't done that yet, watch my quick installation video which is less than 4 minutes long. Also, what are you doing here man? Anywho, you can see the link for that up there. Before we get jiggy with it, here is a short video on what you can create. Whoa, holy Jesus, I just saw some boobies. I blurred this out for the kids at home, but just a fair warning. I asked for apples and coconuts, and I got boobies, and some durian at the end there. I also think I saw a penguin. Then again I can see how the AI can be confused, as fruits are sometimes a sizing chart for things like big coconuts.
Oh, nobody here have big coconuts.
Fear not. You can use --no to take out what you don't want to see. Alrighty, I will say, this is the first time the installation is 1000 times easier than using the actual program. It will take you only 30 seconds to install this, but 1 hour to figure out how to run this thing. With that said, I will give you just the tip of the tip, as I haven't really figured out how to configure this thing properly, and I'm doing a lot of reading. So give me a break on this one. I only use the preset settings for proof of concept, and get a viable working product out the door.
Take a hike.
Let's get started, shall we? Step 1. Download the zip file from the Deforum extension link for automatic 1111, and then clicking on the code button which will uncover the zip file link. Link is in the video description along with all the other links you need. Step 2. Unzip and extract those zip files to your Stable Diffusion folder under the subfolder extensions. Just follow what I did on the screen. Make sure you rename this to something that's not crazy. May I suggest renaming it to Deforum Main? I know. Wild right. Then go back up a level to the main parent folder, and then run the web UI user batch file, and wait for it to update. And give you the message that it is running on your local URL. Step 3, you're already done.
お前はもう死んでいる。何?
So let's see if it's broken or not, shall we? Copy the local URL 127 link that shows up at the end of your web UI console, and paste it into your browser as you normally would when running your Stable D. Just like usual, you have to wait for the web UI to load before you put the local user IP in the address bar, so slow down there, hot rod. Now check out your new tab that says Deforum.
The plan.
Isn't it beautiful? Go ahead and click on it, you know you want to. But before we get into this, the information I will present to you is only be the bare minimum to run this thing, because reading the instructions for this tool makes me feel like a real dummy.
It's a dummy.
But there is a user guide in the description. If you want to get super nerdy with it now, there is trigonometry used in the prompt weights and camera settings. But I barely recall math, and I only get PTSD flashbacks of what it was like.
Well, I'm not a math, real good at math.
I'm not joking, there is a lot of math involved in this tool. You will see cosines, sine, and log 10 equations, but you won't actually have to make a calculation. My understanding is they are added based on a preset equation, and you will just up some of the numbers for more intense output or to go in a certain direction. But don't quote me on that. I will take down this video and say it never happened. I still have to do some math homework and get back to you guys. If you guys figure it out first, maybe you can school me in the comments. I'm not that savvy with this tool right now. And if you don't see a follow-up tutorial, that means I'm too dumb to figure this one out.
I got a good brain.
Before you get started, if you just installed the new Stable Diffusion version 1.5, you need to make sure you are on the main 1.5 file and not the in-painting one. So access the drop-down box at the top, right, and choose the version 1.5 pruned.cpkt and let that model load. So first let's start with the run tab, or sub tab. By now you should be familiar with a lot of these options. The most important change you need to make in the run tab every time you do a video is the batch name. This actually creates a folder in your Stable Diffusion. Main Stable Diffusion folder, outputs. Under image to image for each specific run. So change the batch name every time you run it. It also creates hundreds of pictures in each folder, so that's even more reason you don't want to run it twice with the same name. It's pretty nice that it automatically creates the new folder under the batch name you specified.
Sweet!
If you haven't figured it out by now, this program is doing something similar to how I showed you how to animate an image to video tutorial, but it only requires you type something in, or that you give it one image or one clip.
It's heavy.
If only this thing came out 3 weeks ago, this is much easier to do. Next is the keyframe tab. You have the option to run in 2D, 3D, and video input. If you look at the motion parameters below, this is complete madness.
This is Sparta!
Then 0 in parentheses. The way this works is anything positive with X will go to the right, and positive Y goes up, and I'm not sure how to describe Z. I guess a combination of X and Y equals Z in an eggshell.
Come again?
Also, negative numbers move in the opposite direction. I haven't read enough to give you more information than that right now. Moving on to the prompts, this is where I tap out.
Is about as brutal as it comes, and while we think that Hirota decided not to tap, I wonder maybe his hand was stuck in between Aoki's legs.
I guess that last clip fits under the description, but my hands are tied, anyways. I'm just running the prompt as is right now, but there is some issues with the instructions as the prompt examples in the driver's manual don't match what's currently in the prompt by default, but alas, it works. Perhaps the weirdest thing is there is no mention of FFmpeg, but if you go to the video output tab, it seems the FFmpeg.exe location goes in there before you can even get MPEG files from the output. I'm pretty sure it does. I will experiment with this, but this is probably why, when you choose output format FFmpeg right now, you get a file not found error to at the end, or at least I do. Let me know in the comments if you can create something aside from GIFs. I would just choose the GIF format for now, perhaps when you're feeling froggy.
It's a jump in.
And you want to experiment with it, you can unzip a version of FFmpeg and put the .exe link in the video output section.
You feeling froggy? Then leap.
Keep in mind that all the output paths are currently set to a Google Drive location. You will have to change it to an address on your hard drive and click save at the bottom right. It will seem like nothing happened, but the save confirmation will show up in your web UI or command prompt, and not on the web page. Very important, you will have to click load settings when you close and reopen the app because your saved settings won't be there. Now let's go back a tap to init or init.
Wait, you net?
Yeah, I net.
I really don't understand what's going on here right now, but it seems like where you put image to video or video to video stuff. Actually, that is pretty clear that's what it does, but I'm just not sure how to use it. I will have to get back to you on this feature. Now the big kahuna, or the part that matters the most, running the prompt. At the bottom you will see some preloaded text in the animation prompts box. I would only change the subjects for now until you're savvy with this, and do a bit of reading. In the example they use math weights, but it is not necessary right now and this looks very complicated. Once you got what you want, click on the big orange generate button. And your web UI will start to go crazy, because it's creating hundreds of pictures for you right now. And you can see the generation progress on the browser as well. This is where things go out of hand though. The web UI seems to stop at 43%, but it doesn't seem to matter. Once you click the click here after the generation button, it will turn the PNG in the loaded box into a GIF or video in your image-to-image files. Yes, even though it's a video, so that's your Stable Diffusion main folder, outputs, image-to-image, and it will be in the folder that you named your project. If you didn't name your project like I didn't, it will go in the regular Deforum folder. Do as I say, and not as I do. Oddly enough, there isn't a notice that is generated in the browser or web UI console, so you will just have to check the folder for your GIF or video file. It will be the first or last in the series. You can also look at it in details view to see the file type. Well, there you go. You have the tip of the tip, and just enough to play with it and make weird artsy fartsy videos for cool intros, concept art, or for your own self-amusement. I find these videos to be very entertaining, as they are a formulation of the AI's thoughts and interpretations in real time. It's almost as if the AI has a soul, and it is cognizant of its self-awareness, and is expressing itself through art with the help of your concrete definitions of a moment in time. Or perhaps I'm just delirious and need to go sleep.
You f***ing delirious motherfucker. You were cold as ice.
Okay, that's it for now. I think I will create a site. It would be cool to see everyone's artwork for better or worse. But in the meantime, and as always, sayonara, aloha, adios, thegia, alavida, aniyan, paralam, and please come again.
Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all. Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all.
Too many things going on, I can't keep track of them all. From people dropping a bomb to people putting up walls, I feel like life is on hold, perception stuck in a vault. I know that time can heal all, but how much time till we fall? It's awfully chilly outside when there's no shelter to hide. When everything is a lie, you'll find that out in some time. But when the things on your mind are all considered a crime, communication aside, we'll all just fight till we die.
Is this an argument or just the start of it? Either way, I don't wanna be a part of it. Can I just get some space? I don't have the heart for this. I can't be picking up the pieces, fixing scars from this. Is this an argument or just the start of it? I wanna drive away so I can be so far from it. I wanna find a place where no one breaks their promises. Or maybe drown myself in something that is bottomless.
Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all. Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all.
I know that things seem bad, but they could be much worse. There's always someone else who has a greater curse, a greater thirst, a hunger, pain, and mercy. Just find whatever you got and try to be thankful first. I wanna feel again, I need a couple friends. I never really understood just how the story ends, but I can feel it's tense, don't know the consequence. The volatility of life, my only confidence.
Is this an argument or just the start of it? Either way, I don't wanna be a part of it.